They called her black. Gave her melanin, the persona of evil, dark, saddened, and whatever else the collective writers of Webster saw fit to describe her skin. Her epidermis layer was much like the coffee they sipped, black and bitter. They called her sinister, because in their minds, her tar skin seduced them. She asked for it. They labeled her color, then beat her blue. They ripped her coarse hair, hangnails snagged at her curls, definition naps. Their blue veins pulsated with power above their pale knuckles. White, definition pure males invaded her her pink so deep their faces became colored cherry. As they popped hers, her face just remained black. In the pit of the night, in the pit of herself, in a pit they left her. Moonlight glossed over the blood on her thighs. She bled their evils. They stole the ritual of a period ending the sentence of her childhood before her body's clock was able to drain the lining out of her uterus. They drained the color out of her skin. She quickly learned the definition of white and wrong. A white man's burden swallowed her belly. A black woman's struggle was shackled to her adolescent ankle. She walked the fields in the blood so heavy her shins gained a permanent splint. They called her black. Then define black as the absence of color. They want to pretend to be absent from color, but they raked lighter shades of brown into the color wheel and then tried to abort it. She held that child with a mind distorted, already knowing full well what's in store for it, that her father will sell her as a silver polisher. Definition in-house mulatto slave who will be fucked by the master, then jealously slapped by the missus. And she knows because she was cursed with this same beauty. And no parent wants their child to end up like them, but when the systematic auctioning of a child is legal and protecting one from the crack of a whip is not, it is hard to try to mold a child who has been chiseled into a statue of limitations, but the only limitation is the mother's will to save him. They called her black. But what will Webster and his colleagues know about the word black? Because black worked the soil they walked on. Black used to hang where their children's tires now swing. Black nursed their great-great-grandfathers. Black is innovative and intellectual and all three-thirds of a person and lingers in the cotton fibers of their t-shirts. Black was created in the Middle Passage by men who felt threatened by our dark skin, threatened by their attraction to the beauty of a black woman. They called her black, but her name was Edith. And she will soon have a great-great-granddaughter who will not see her struggle as beautiful, but 15 pages of a history book that they won't seek to understand. And if she ever saw the scars on her great-great-grandmother's back, she would quote the 13th Amendment and give praises to our great white savior, Abraham Lincoln, like it can close the trenches of her wounds. And she'll call Edith's history black, unaware of the history of the word itself.